Tools like ChatGPT can soon be upgraded to autonomous bots. And last week, we saw an open source project called AutoGPT that modeled what this could be like. In today's video, I'll explore how prompt engineering could change with the introduction of autonomous bots, with a comparison between prompts for ChatGPT and AutoGPT. To recap on what AutoGPT introduced, it's a GitHub project powered by GPT to create a rudimentary AGI bot that can autonomously define and execute tasks to achieve your objectives, with capabilities like Google search, long-term memory, local file storage, and text-to-speech. AutoGPT easily executes multi-stage conversations with minimal human interaction. If you want to know how to set up AutoGPT, check out the step-by-step setup guide. The link is in the description. Hi, I'm Dave, and I asked a friend to watch that video and give me feedback. They replied, "Why would I want to use AutoGPT when I already love ChatGPT? I have prompts that I love, chats that I have trained. GPT already seems to learn from itself, and there are no daunting installation requirements. I'm unsure if the balance of effort and benefit is worth the time." I replied quickly, "You would not need to use this as a replacement for specific chats that you have trained. You can keep using the workflows that you love and trust. I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And after all, AutoGPT is just an open source proof of concept project." But I did follow up with a second reply on how the nature of prompt writing could evolve with the introduction of autonomous bots, and I thought I would share it with you. As a prompt engineer, I have many types of chats that I use daily. The three most common, from my point of view, are the throwaway, the scalpel, and the winding path. These are not chat prompts, but more like chat styles that I use to get the most out of ChatGPT. The throwaway. There are many types of throwaway conversations that I engage in during the day. These are usually ideas that I want to explore in the moment, but I don't want to mix them into normal chat workflows, mainly because I do not want to mess up the short-term memory of a chat that is currently working well. Example: summarize this article into bullet points, 5 to 8 words per point. Then I throw in some sort of article, and I use that output in a different chat window. The scalpel. I also have task-oriented chat sessions. These chat bots are primed with an expert advisor, a reset set of guidelines, plus examples, and a repeatable output structure. I use this technique when I need production line and repeatable workers. For example, YouTube titles. The winding path. The winding path bot will start with an expert advisor, a topic or an outcome, and is directly guided by me. The main role is to research, summarize, expand, or maybe even transform information from one style to another. The researcher. I use the research bot whenever I am trying to evaluate an idea. Unlike the other three bots, I don't always know what rabbit hole to go down when I start this bot. I know that there will be different topics researched. Often using Google search, I produce many files in the form of documents, spreadsheets, or mind maps, and sometimes generate some concept art in tools like Midjourney. And it is this style of prompt engineering that I feel will fit well with the introduction of autonomous bots. So let's look at 7 examples that I use for manual chat conversations by exploring the throwaway, scalpel, and winding path styles. After that, I will show a single prompt using the researcher style. Think of these as individual chat sessions that you might open during the day. So chat number 1 in the style of the throwaway. You are an expert in writing YouTube titles. What are 50 ingredients for a great YouTube title? And then I store this output in youtubetitleformula.txt. Chat number 2, another throwaway. You are an expert in writing YouTube descriptions. What are 10 things you would tell someone to write a good YouTube description. Then I store this information in YouTube description formula.txt. Chat number three, the winding path style. You are a copywriting expert specializing in the psychology of marketing titles that convert. You worked for years with brands such as Vogue and GQ magazine. I engaged this bot in a conversation about psychology of marketing titles that convert for as long as needed. I stored this output into copywriting psychology. Chat number four, another throwaway. You are going to help me create a job description with roles and responsibilities for a YouTube title specialist. Use as input YouTube title formula and copywriting psychology. Then generate a YouTube title specialist position or role. Then I store this information in clickbait YouTube title formula. Chat number five, another throwaway. Similar to chat four, but for YouTube description specialist. The input is from YouTube description formula and the copywriting psychology documents. I ask it to generate a YouTube description specialist position or role, and I store this information in the clickbait YouTube description formula. Chat number six, using the scalpel style, which means that it's a repeatable style that I can use over and over again. And I start it with, you will generate awesome YouTube titles for me. I give it the input from clickbait YouTube title formula, and then I ask it to create a title, removing backgrounds from Canva. Here I have an example where the input is, you are an expert in YouTube video title creation, and the guidelines are a list of best practices for YouTube titles. Whenever I want to use this trained prompt, I just write keyword and a simple title, and I get a list of 10 excellent YouTube titles every time. And chat number seven, example of the scalpel style, you will generate awesome YouTube descriptions for me. I give it as input the clickbait YouTube descriptions formula, and then the prompt is simply create description, and the title I'll use is removing backgrounds from Canva. I paste in the transcription from whatever video this was from, and it just produces an awesome description that I can use in my YouTube videos. As I was testing prompts that would work with this software, I realized that the ideas suggested in the project README were pretty much the same as the technique that I use when researching a complex topic. Roll this into a pattern that can work with autonomous, self-directing GPT bots. Based on the seven individual chats that I just explained, it would look something like this. Name, YouTube marketing expert. Description, you will research how to be a YouTube content marketing expert. You will research and save topics into a file. And finally, create some usable prompts. And then I just give it a list of goals to achieve. Goal number one, research how to be a YouTube title expert. Store it in YouTube title formula. Two, research how to be a YouTube description expert. Store it in YouTube description formula. Three, research how to be a copywriting expert specializing in the psychology of marketing titles that convert. Store in copywriting psychology. Four, create a job description for a YouTube title expert. Store it in clickbait YouTube title formula. Five, create a job description for a YouTube description expert. Store it in clickbait YouTube description formula. Six, generate a new chatbot that I can use to create YouTube titles from very simple inputs. And lastly, number seven, generate a new chatbot that I can use to create YouTube descriptions from these very simple inputs, plus the video transcription. So let's see if a basic version of this technique would work with AutoGPT. Now please note that the open source project does not support seven goals. Also, it fails quickly with complex prompts. So for now, I will just demonstrate the prompt I used in the original tutorial. I gave the AI a name, I called it Product Inventor. Next, I gave it a role, and its role was to take three products and come up with a new product that blends the ideas. Finally, I gave it three products: scented candles, yoga mats, and relaxing music. Now, I can enter up to five, but if you press enter on an empty line, it'll just kick off the bot. Now, the first thing that the bot does is it reflects on what its own thoughts are on the project. The goal is to come up with a new product that blends the ideas of scented candles, yoga mats, and relaxation music. So it works out that it should research the benefits that those products bring by finding the commonalities between them. It then reasons for itself that it needs a deeper understanding of the products and how blending them can inform its future decisions. It also understands that it needs to create a product that will be revolutionary. So it comes up with a plan: conduct research on scented candles, yoga mats, and relaxation music, look for their commonalities, and brainstorm ideas for potential new products. The last piece, criticism, is really powerful because bots can have a problem with going down rabbit holes in a direction that the author didn't intend. And so it tells us that it needs to ensure that it's taking the time to thoroughly research each product and should not jump to any conclusions too quickly. It then creates its next command and asks for guidance. So the command is a Google search on the benefits of scented candles, yoga mats, and relaxation music. So now it's looking for input from the user. So let's break this down. If you just want it to execute the next command, press yes to authorize. If you want to steer the way it's thinking, then just give it some feedback in the form of a prompt. If you are finished with all the commands that the bot has run, you can press end to exit the program. You might have noticed that I skipped the continuous command, which is yes followed by a dash n. The reason is that the chatbot will actually run automatically and spawn a lot of requests to different services, such as the Google Search API, the ChatGPT API, the Pinecone API, and you could rack up a really hefty bill with some of these services if you're not paying attention. Now, with this understanding in place, let's press Y. So we can see at this point, it's gone and researched some information on various websites like Lullify, Studio Growth, Healthline, and it's putting all this information into its long-term memory in Pinecone. Now, if you look at the inventor thoughts, reasoning, plan, and criticism, you'll notice that there's not a lot of difference in this next action it's about to take and the previous action. So we'll press Y and see what it does differently. And it looks like it's just continuing its research. It's gone to Twitter, Amazon, Yoga Rascals, and other URLs to get information. It now looks like the bot has done enough research on the products themselves and decided that what it needs to do now is how can it blend these products together in a unique and effective way. And now it's coming up with a lot of information that it's committing to its long-term memory in Pinecone. And from this information, decides to research marketing strategies around wellness products, followed by consumer preferences for wellness products. Now, I let the bot run for a while, pressing yes each time, until I get to this section. Because here it ran a new command called write to file, and you can see it's written out a file called productpitch.txt with a whole lot of content. And what's great is that it's not just in the Pinecone memory, but it's now out in a file where I can use it. So the bot continues for a little while doing different searches, building up a knowledge base, and then it gets to this section. It's about to write a report for me in Markdown format, and this will be great because I'll be able to use it to develop presentations and social media assets. Now the bot actually had an error and failed to write out the report to the file. But as you can see, it is all here. So I just copied this and put it into my own Markdown file, and you can view it here. I then used a manual prompt asking it to give me a hierarchical list of tasks that it had worked on. It failed with the command, but it still gave the list, and I was able to just move this straight into a mind map. I pressed no to exit. Then I proceeded to develop a bunch of assets in Midjourney and Canva and create these two presentations. The interesting thing is that Canva has an API, so a lot of the presentation work could have been done automatically as well. And while Midjourney doesn't currently have an API, other platforms like Stable Diffusion, DALL-E, and the up-and-coming Firefly by Adobe will. Well, that's a wrap on today's deep dive into the world of prompt engineering and autonomous bots. I hope you found this exploration of ChatGPT versus AutoGPT prompt writing useful. If you enjoyed the video and found it informative, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Remember to subscribe to the channel for more insightful content about prompt engineering for non-engineers.